Hello and welcome to part 5 of Pulling the Perfect Key in DaVinci Resolve, with me, Ben Brownlee from Boris FX. In this section, we're going to start tying our composite together by adding in elements both behind and in front of our subject and see how we can make this a holistic shot rather than two separate elements put together. You'll notice that I'm back in the edit room. And the reason for that is that because we're going to be adding some more elements in, I'm actually going to bring these in as separate layers. Now, because we're going to be using effects, I could actually put these on top of the layers, the video layers we already have, but I actually like the flexibility of having these as a separate clip. So let's add our first element behind our hero. I'm just going to grab the green screen clip and put it onto video track 3. And let's come up and open up my effects library. And I'm going to look at generators, because these are effects that create their own clip. And in our toolbox, we have the standard Resolve generators. So we have solid colors, color bars, four color gradients, all that sort of fun stuff. But if we open up the generators or take a look at the generators in Open Effects, we also have the Continuum generators too. And I'm not going to look too far from the top. I'm just going to grab a BCC lens flare and I'm going to put it onto video track 2, so between my background and my foreground. And I'll extend that out. Now, you'll see that we've got a little bit of weirdness happening right about now. And this is absolutely normal for Resolve, unfortunately. The reason for this is that in the current version of Resolve 16.1, if we've got the render cache turned on to smart, this sort of thing happens quite a bit. So if I turn my render cache off, then open up the inspector, come into the generator controls, into OFX, and just make any change there, and you'll see that now my lens flare is acting as it should do. So we just have to bypass the render cache. Great, and now with the lens flare 3D, I'm going to open up the effects browser and take a quick look and see if I can find a preset that is going to help me get started with the effect that I'm looking for. And the FX browser is available in all of the Continuum filters. That's a nice way of sort of figuring out what the filters can start to do. I actually quite like the quick take DD and I like the soft flare colored fog. That's always a good go-to for me. I'm going to go with a quick take though and hit apply on that. And let's just start moving this into place, because what I want to do with this flare is I want to motivate this lighting that we have on our hero on the right hand side. If we turn this off, you can see we've got a really nice rim light on the right hand side of the screen here. But if we take a look at the forest, there's not a lot of sunshine coming in through those trees. So we're just going to motivate that lighting with a lens flare. So just put in a bit of light there. So a dead giveaway is where the lighting just doesn't match between foreground and background. I'm going to turn my Open Effects overlay back on. And I can use this just to come in and sort of bring my light up here. So let's just zoom out a little bit. Now I could get us a nice, like proper natural motivated light, like this one here. Or I could go for something a little bit more stylistic and sort of have a hero light just coming right from the back like that, which I actually quite like. So I'm gonna go with that for the time being. We'll see how this works out. Now on the lens flare, I can make lots of different changes to this. I just sort of want that flare feel to it. The rays I'm gonna keep on. I'm just gonna take that scale down though, so it's not going quite as far out. And I'm going to do the same thing with the flare. I'm going to actually just open up the flare and just take the intensity down just a little bit. Quite a lot. So we get a sense of just kind of a diffuse light coming through the trees. Let's have a little playback of that. It's not going to play back at real time now. And because we've turned our render cache off for the time being, we're going to be getting sort of slower playback. but it should be enough to let us know whether that's working or not. So now we've got stuff that's behind our subject. I want to tie this together by having something over the top of our image as well. And this could be something as simple as putting a little bit of grain on top, just something that ties everything together so that it looks like it was shot at the same time with the same camera. So a bit of grain or a bit of atmosphere. I think that's what I'm going to do with this one, is add in a bit of atmosphere. And I'm going to use another generator. And I'm going to use particle illusion. So let's bring that down over the top. And that will push us on to video track 4. If we haven't got video track 4, that'll just put it in there automatically for us. And let's have a look at this. So open up my OFX again. And I'm just going to launch Particle Illusion. And Particle Illusion is a 2D particle system. If I just come up to have a look at the browse here, you can see that it ships with thousands of different types of presets. So we've got lots of fire that we can use. There we go, nice bit of fire. And I can also search in the emitters here as well. So if I wanted to look for something watery, I've got some watery stuff that I can work with, or something a bit more realistic. We've got falling splashes or rain. We've got lots of different types of rain we can start to be using. Now, in this case, I want to use something a little bit dusty. And I've got a preset here that I really like, and it's called Magic Light Shaft. We get a feeling of what it is, but let's have an actual look. If I go back into the default viewer, I'm just going to double click on this to load it onto the stage. And Magic Light Shaft uses a line emitter, so it means we've got, you know, multiple points that we can be using. I'm just going to click one more time to set my point and then hit escape. And then that's it. That's my Magic Light Shaft. So if we just play that back, see, we've got a light shaft with some dust falling through it. What I'm going to do is have it coming from the right-hand side over to the left-hand side. So what I need to do with this is just change the angle on my emitter. So what I'm just going to do is just change the angle of the emitter there and not make it any more difficult than that. Just put it over this side. That's kind of nice. That's going to work. We'll hit apply, and this will take us back into the Resolve interface. And let's play that back. Yeah, that's sort of working for me. Now, particle illusion, I can do different things with this. I can even transform this up and either transform the emitter or transform the world. And as before, we can use our on-screen. There we go. We use our on-screen controls to determine where this starts. There we go. So I just want to sort of hit where he is. I don't want to sort of go completely over his face. Well, we could do that, but that wouldn't be great. So I'm just going to, again, just add a little bit sort of feeling of magic in here without going too far. And when I'm happy with that, probably a good idea to come back and we'll turn our render cache back on again. We're not adding lots of other different effects or generators in here anymore, so we're not going to get those same problems that we had previously. And the timeline slowly moves from red to blue. So now that the next time that I play this through, we'll see this in real time and see if we need to make any changes to it. So we've seen in this exercise how we can start to bring things together by unifying the lighting and by adding a bit of atmosphere over the top of our entire scene. It doesn't have to be something as big as an atmosphere effect. It could be a grain effect. Just anything to bring these different clips into the same world. In the next and final part of the series, we're going to be looking at finishing touches. So we're going to be looking at edge details and what we can do there. And we're also going to be looking at doing a final round of color correction. And what's the best way of doing that? Avoiding any sort of duplication in our workflow, whilst making sure that we're not locked into a look that we don't actually like. So thanks very much for joining me so far. My name is Ben Brownlee from Boris Effects, and this is Pulling the Perfect Key in DaVinci Resolve. If you're enjoying it so far, please remember to hit the like button before you watch the next video. You can also subscribe for more videos by hitting the big button there. If you've got any comments, questions, then remember to ask it in the comments section below. If you want to follow along with this, use the download link in the description.